There is a new battery for electric vehicles in China, which is 3 times more energy dense than Tesla's 46AD battery. This battery pouch packs 3 times more energy than a Tesla battery 4680 that we know. But I need to warn you, this is still research level work and needs to cross many hurdles before it becomes commercially available in a Tesla or another electric vehicle. But this research is very interesting, and I'm going to compare this battery with Tesla's 4680 batteries. Welcome back, everyone. Researchers at the Institute of Physics at the Chinese Academy of Sciences have set a new record by packing in 711 watt-hour per kilogram of energy density inside a single battery pack. You may wonder, okay, what does this mean? This is currently three times the capacity of battery packs used for electric vehicles on average these days, especially the one from Tesla, the 4680 battery. 3 times more. With the focus on shifting to electric modes of transportation, energy density is a hurdle that researchers are looking to overcome. Higher energy densities increase power availability in vehicles, thereby increasing their range or payload capacities. While electric vehicles with 621-mile range make one assume that researchers have achieved decent success so far, higher energy battery packs are crucial for electrifying long-haul transport, but over water and air. The research from the Institute of Physics is a major step in this direction. The research team led by Li Hong and Hyang Yu, professors of the National Research Center for Condensed Matter Physics in Beijing, developed a 10Ah class soft pack lithium secondary battery. The pouch was developed using an ultra thin lithium metal anode and a manganese oxide based cathode, which was also rich in lithium. The electrodes were tested by the China North Vehicle Research Institute. Intending to increase the energy storage density, the team expanded the charge-discharge voltage range while keeping an eye on the structural capabilities of the cathode and the anode, as lithium ions deposited on the electrodes and dissolved into the battery during the charging and discharging process. Additionally, they also use diaphragm coating technology to improve it. Finally, the researchers were able to record an average density of 711.30 watt-hour per kilogram and a volumetric energy density of 1,653.65 WHL, which is far higher than what commercially available electric vehicle battery packs offer today. Now, to put this in context and compare it to Tesla, Tesla's 4680 cells that Tesla plans to use in its upcoming models have an energy density of 244 watt-hour per kilogram. This one that has been achieved in China is 711.30 watt-hour per kilogram, 3 times more than Tesla. Interest in packing batteries with more energy has been propelling the technology forward since the time Sony showcased the commercial application of lithium-ion technology way back in 1991. So what do you think, friends, about this? Among many other things, this battery pack's sole focus was maximizing energy density. The researchers know this very well and agree that there is huge scope for improvement in their design. Nevertheless, a new record has been set for energy that can be stored in an electric vehicle battery, and may just be the first step in our dream of achieving an all-electric long-haul flight. And who knows, if they succeed with this, maybe Tesla will buy batteries from them, and the industry will slowly learn how to make these batteries, and in several years we might have Tesla vehicles or other electric vehicles running beyond 1,000 miles per single charge. Let me know your thoughts. Are you excited about this? This is Armin Harayan from TorqueNews.com. Please subscribe to our channel for daily Tesla news. God bless you, and I'll see you soon in our next report. I have a breaking news about Tesla's 4680 battery cell production friends. Just about an hour ago, Tesla announced a major milestone in 4680 cell ramp at Gigafactory Texas. Welcome back, everyone. This is Armin Harayan from TorqueNews.com. If you are here first time, please take a moment and subscribe to our channel for daily Tesla news and ring the bell so you don't miss my next coverage. So Tesla just about an hour ago announced a major milestone in the ramp of the 4680 battery cell at Gigafactory Texas, confirming it has produced 10 million battery cells at the plant. Imagine 10 million 4680 battery cells at Gigafactory Texas. Tesla has been building 4680 cells for several years after unveiling the technology behind the battery in late 2020. Initially starting production at the Cato Road facility in Northern California, just near the Fremont factory, Tesla expanded 4680 manufacturing at Gigafactory Texas after vehicle production began and has been using the batteries in the all-wheel drive Model Y. Tesla has been selling these Model Ys for over a year now, and the ramp-up of 4680 technology has continued. After aiming to begin production of 4680 cells in quarter 3 2022, Tesla has evidently ramped the manufacturing of the battery up considerably, announcing it has built 10 million cells in Gigafactory Texas earlier today. Like I said, just about an hour ago. The 10 million cells produced are enough to build roughly 12,000 Model Y vehicles. Don't think that these 10 million cells, meaning 10 million enough batteries for 10 million vehicles. No, the 10 million battery cells produced are enough to build roughly 12,000 Model Y vehicles. Outside of Texas, Tesla is hoping to continue ramping up 4680 production to supplement vehicles that will be fitted with those packs. In Fremont, California, Tesla just leased a massive 210,000 plus square foot facility that will be used for 4680 manufacturing, helping to get more cars with the breakthrough battery technology on the road. It's a huge building. Last year, CEO of Tesla, Elon Musk, said 4680 battery cells would be an important part of Tesla's plans in 2023. Evidently, ramping up production of these cells and getting more 4680 packs into the company's electric vehicle is a goal moving forward, and hopefully Tesla can reach a point where they are not limited with how many vehicles they can build, as cell constraints have been an industry-wide issue for years. So I congratulate Tesla for this milestone and for building more 4680 batteries for their vehicles. And I think this by next year, we should see more numbers, better numbers coming up from Tesla in this regard. What do you think, friends? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below.